I was just rather depressed. At any rate, we know the worst now. They've all arrived.
Nothing.
Call it the Culver Street murderer. Oh.
A thousand pardons. I am, where am I?
This is Monkswell Manor guest house.
But what stupendous good fortune! Madame! What an handsome refrain. A guest house. A charming hostess. My Rolls Royce Ness is running to a snowdrift. Blinding snow everywhere. Perhaps I am afraid that I will freeze to death. And then I take a little bag, I stagger through the snow. I see before me big iron gates. A habitation, I am saved. Twice I fall into the snow as I come up your drive, and finally, despair turns to joy. You can let me have a room, yes?
Oh, yes.
It's a rather small one, I'm afraid.
Oh, naturally, naturally. You have other guests.
We're only just starting this place as a guest house today, and so we're quite new at it.
Charming. Charming.
What about your luggage?
Oh, that is of no consequence. I have unlocked the car securely.
Wouldn't it be better to get in it?
Oh, no. I can assure you, on such a night as this, I have all that I need in here, in this little bag. Yes. All that I need.
You better get thoroughly warm.
See.
I'll see about your room. I'm afraid it's a rather cold room because it faces north, but all others are occupied.
You have several guests then.
Yes. There's Mrs. Boyle and Major Metcalf and Miss Casewell, and a young woman called Chris Rent. And now you.
Yes. Yes. The unexpected guest. The guest who just arrived from nowhere out of the storm. It's quite dramatic, is it not? Who am I? You do not know. Where do I come from? You do not know. Me, I am the man of mystery. But now I tell you this. I complete the picture. By tomorrow, perhaps even already, we are cut off from everything. No butcher, no baker, no milkman, no postman, no daily papers, nobody, and nothing but ourselves. That is admirable. Admirable. My name, by the way, is Paravicini.
Oh, yes. Ours is Ralston.
Mr. and Mrs. Ralston. And this is Monkswell Manor Guest House. Monkswell Manor Guest House. Perfetto!